Apparently, camera is not a personal stuff. Videos of weddings? Unfortunately, these are the rules and we need to follow them. Hello folks, hello travelers. I want to share with you what happened with me on Serbian-Bosnian border customs a few days ago. While I was crossing the border and on the customs, the guy asked me if I have something to declare. Well, I told them no, I have only my personal stuff. I really had my personal stuff with me. Apparently, camera is not a personal stuff. Like different custom officers explained me that according Bosnian laws, when you enter the country, you need to declare your camera, your lens, chargers, light maybe, tripod, and any other device. So personal stuff is only phone and laptop. I really don't understand how camera is not personal stuff. If you will not declare your camera, they will confiscate it. You will pay penalty, import duty, like custom tax. Then they will sue you. I mean, there will be a court. And this is so not logical. Well, countries in Balkans, they are so small. And sometimes you need like a few hours to go from one country to another country. Just imagine on weekend. And apparently you need to declare your camera with you. Well, all countries on Balkans, they are so proud with steps they do for tourism. Well, good luck if you will not let tourists to bring their camera to make photos and videos of the places they want to make. I do realize that millions of tourists enter Bosnia and other Balkan countries without declaring their camera, but that's not because law lets them do that. That's just because custom officers don't care. They just don't want to be bothered with that. And that is not correct. I prefer to follow rules, to follow laws. And if law is wrong, well, I still will follow that law, but will complain. I really don't understand why camera is not a personal stuff and need to be declared. And the smartphone is a personal stuff and doesn't need to be declared. I really don't understand that. Well, there are two things. One, because of its price. Second, because what it does. Well, if it's because of the price, well, my smartphone is much more expensive than my camera. And I really don't understand why I should declare camera and should not declare my smartphone. Or if it's because what it does, well, both my smartphone and my cameras do videos. Even my smartphone do 4K videos when my camera do only HD. And the argument custom officers told me is so weak. Well, the explanation of why camera should be declared is that some people cross the border, make videos of weddings, go back to their country and don't pay taxes. Videos of weddings? Well, that's so weird argument. Well, if you decide to come to Bosnia or any other Balkan countries, be sure to make a list of all devices you have with you. Your camera, your lenses, your phone in case, your lights, your tripod, and write that you will use them for your personal purposes. Try to have invoices for them. Well, who keeps invoice? I have no idea. Write the year. So to show that your devices are old, because if they decide device is new, they will charge it with the price, with the new price. And apparently you have a limit of 300 euros. So if you bring something a little bit expensive, you need to pay import duties. Well, another part, what I really don't understand, and it's not only in Bosnia, in all other countries, why we pay import duties, why we pay custom tax. Import duties and taxes are imposed to limit the attractiveness to consumers of overseas goods or to raise revenue. The reasons vary, but it is usually to protect industry within the country. Sometimes it is to protect the country's ability to be self-sufficient. Well, let me explain you what is this. Country A produce cameras. They pay salary, they pay taxes. You, a person who live here, also pay taxes, salaries. You do not buy camera here and go to another country and buy camera there. Well, by this, you indirectly damage the business of this company in this country because they pay all those things. And to protect his rights, the government adds import taxes, well, custom taxes. So if you buy something that they do from another country, you pay this custom tax? Well, that is actually a normal thing. I really don't know any company in Bosnia that can compete with Canon or Nikon. I really don't know. If I buy camera from another country, what business I will damage in Bosnia? It's not just Bosnia, it's same in Azerbaijan, same in Russia, same in other countries. Just the countries like Germany, UK, United States, France, they do manufacture cameras. And I do understand when someone import camera from other countries there. Yes, that I understand. But small countries like Bosnia, Serbia, Montenegro, Azerbaijan, Georgia, well, I don't know any company there that can manufacture the camera that competes with Canon and Nikon. Well, whose business I damage in this case? No one's. And unfortunately, custom officers have freedom on this step. They will confiscate your camera, for example, send it to court. Court will decide that you need to pay penalty, then they will decide that you need to pay some import taxes, and then maybe they will return your camera. So just imagine you plan to spend in the country 2 days, and this will take a month to take your camera back. Unfortunately, these are the rules and we need to follow them. Doesn't matter how stupid these rules are. Well, next time when you come to Bosnia, be sure to have a list of devices you have with you, and write there that you plan to use these devices for your own purposes. And entering the country, ask custom officer to put a stamp on them. So when you leave the country, other officer who will feel the freedom will not use that and will not create you the problems. Thank you for watching. I hope this experience will help you somehow, prevent you from the problems. So next time you come to the country, be sure to have the list of the devices you have with you. Thank you. Bye-bye.